acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, our rock and our redeemer. Amen. Do please be seated, friends. Thank you for your welcome. It was a lovely, shiny, sunny day yesterday, at least for part of it. And I went on your Facebook page and it said, Bishop Paul Bayes is coming to preach, and then next to it said, tomorrow, thunderstorms. Well, I hope the thunderstorms are just outside and not inside. The sun is shining here inside. And we're most grateful, my three companions and I, for the welcome. Both that Bishop Ted Gulick and Barbara have given us since we came yesterday. And for the welcome we've received from you, fellow Christians, within the one family of Jesus Christ worldwide. That family which is to be extended today as we baptize, and enriched today as we confirm people into their ministries and their dignity as children of God. In Revelation it says, I saw no temple in the city, for its temple is the Lord God, the Almighty, and the Lamb. And then the images rolled out from Scripture of the street, the place where people are and where they pursue their business, glittering with the water of life that flows from the throne of God and of the Lamb. The water of life that bears the name of Jesus Christ. And it is into that ministry, the ministry of sharing and manifesting the living word and truth of God in the street, that you guys are to be confirmed and that you are to be baptized, and that all of us who have ever been baptized or confirmed are inaugural. When I was made Bishop of Liverpool, if you've never been, woe betide you. But Liverpool, until you go, I'll tell you, is in the northwest of England. And I stood there in our cathedral church on the day that I was introduced to the diocese. And I spoke of the street, that same street down which the water of life flows in our reading today. And I said, down that street there is also a table, the table of the poor carpenter, Jesus Christ, who wants everyone to sit at that table and to eat with him. And I said, wherever you sit, along that table which stretches down every street and into every home, wherever you sit, the poor Christ will come and sit beside you. And he will feed you, as he will feed us all today, from his table. But then he will hand you a plate, and he will hand you some food. And very gently he will say to you, I have fed you, now will you go and feed others? Please hold that image in your minds as you set out on your confirmed life. Hold that image, friends, in your minds as a congregation, that the poor Christ who feeds us and fills us with his life equips us then to feed others. And lay alongside that image, which is the Liverpool image, lay alongside that the Warrenton image, water, crystal water, flowing down the street for the thirsty. And the trees of life bearing fruit 12 times as often as they usually do for the healing of the nations. It is into a great dignity and a great responsibility that we are baptized. And we ask for the prayers of strengthening on our sisters and brothers and on one another each day, that we may enter into that dignity afresh. And feed the poor who are starving in this world and those whose souls are starving, with the twin fruits of Jesus and justice. 3 days ago, it was my privilege in New York to meet your presiding bishop, Bishop Michael Curry, and he and I spoke together about the shared vision which he has brought so clearly to the world church, and which we in England are privileged to be in line with, that we proclaim the name of Jesus Christ and that we feed the hungry. Jesus and justice is the dignity of our ministry. And in this reading from Revelation, we see the vision unfolded of fruitfulness and of beauty. And as we pray in a few minutes, all of us, for these candidates for baptism and confirmation, whether or not you're close to them as friends and family, whether you simply know them as members of this people, pray for them that they may enrich that dignified ministry into which across the world we have been called. And so in Liverpool we speak of a bigger church to make a bigger difference. And we say more people knowing Jesus, more justice in the world. Exactly the words used by Bishop Michael 3 days ago in conversation with me. He said, I'm a Jesus and justice guy. And I felt one with him in that. I come from Liverpool, which owes a great deal to the United States, not least a song. The football teams in Liverpool, and in particular Liverpool Football Club, sing this song, written by Rodgers and Hammerstein, one of your greatest gifts to the world. From the musical Carousel, relax friends, I'm not going to sing it. The song you will know is called You'll Never Walk Alone. And in Liverpool just this week, we have received news after 27 years. There was a terrible tragedy. Football fans were killed and trampled in a terrible accident 27 years ago. And for all those years, their families have pushed through for justice and truth to be revealed because they were blamed for their own deaths. And after 27 years, just this last week, the jury of the inquest said the fans were not responsible. And the whole city was lifted, because that patient pursuit of justice had been vindicated. And together across the city, people sang that song, You'll Never Walk Alone. And I have said in many sermons in Liverpool at confirmation services and baptism services, it is the gift of Jesus Christ to us that we will never walk alone. We are born up by the community of the church across the world and across the denominations and across the races, one family redeemed. We do not walk alone. These young people to be baptized, these adults to make their baptism their own, enter into hundreds of millions of companions walking the road to Jesus and justice. The vision is a vision of human flourishing. The way is the way together. And so in the gospel, Jesus says, I've said these things to you while I'm still with you, but the advocate, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you everything. We have an advocate. We do not stand alone before the court of God. We do not stand alone in the street when we speak of Jesus and feed the poor. We have the Lord himself alongside us by his Spirit. We do not walk alone. And as I bring you today, friends, the greetings and the love of the Diocese of Liverpool, England, I assure you that we pray for you all as you pray for your friends, as together we pray that we may enter the dignity of the worldwide church, that the water clear as crystal may flow down the lonely streets and the lonely homes of this parish and this region, that the table of the poor Christ may be extended down these streets and into your neighbors' homes, that you with your hand will feed them with the life of God, the name of Jesus proclaimed, the poor fed, all drawn together into the vision of wholeness. Of this we speak in Easter time. This we celebrate today. Into this our friends are inaugurated. And your prayer I charge you to make this prayer, is that everything that God has put in their lives may come to fruition as confirmed and baptized members of the church. They take their stand.